Station.
The Randi Rhodes Show. Turn up your mind.
It's almost Memorial Day, so let's not forget to remember on Memorial Day those that we lost, including right there, that body redhead, the unbelievable woman who broke into the all boys club comedy, tour. Rusty Warren, she just passed away. I found out through a mutual friend. She passed away at 91 years old.
Oh!
91. a lot of you only know that song. You don't know that that song is Rusty Warren. Some of you do know that that song is Rusty Warren. Most of you did not know who Rusty Warren was until that song. And, it's kind of sad and insane because that woman right there in the 50s and in the 60s had 15 albums. 15 albums, yes. And it was during that era of party albums. That's what they had to be called. This was before Tipper Gore and the parental advisory, era, right? Which was totally directed at hip-hop, just say that. But before everything parental and advisory was, pointed at hip-hop, you had people pointing at sexual content. And that's considered sexual content. That was considered sexual content. And so of the 15 albums that Rusty Warren actually put out, she sold millions of albums. She was on the Billboard 200 for over 3 years with that album, okay, called Knockers Up. You know why? Because she was trying to tell women to be proud, to throw their shoulders back, knockers up, right? To stand proud. That's what this message was about. Anyway, she had 15 albums. They were all labeled party albums. Like Red Fox was labeled a party album. Chris Rush was labeled a party album. Anything that dealt with anything that was mature or something that we all did had to be labeled as bad. And so that's why she never became a household name, you know. But this album that song comes off of is from 1960, believe it or not. And it was called Knockers Up, and it stayed on the Billboard 200 for over 3 years. 3 years. And she was considered too risque for TV. Hello, everybody. I'm on the TV. Can you believe that crap? But yeah, she was considered too risque. She really did. She never cursed. I've heard almost all her albums. I've never heard her use a swear word ever. And she was sort of kind of banned from television. But she led an amazing life. She was a hero of mine. She's been an inspiration for me as soon as I discovered her. Her work, I think I discovered her work or found out about, the stuff that she was making back in the 50s. I think I realized this around, I don't know, the late 90s, somewhere around there. I'm going to say I found her around 98 or 99. And, by playing her song, she was literally able to go out and do some more shows. And I'm really proud that we had any little tiny little smidgen of anything to do with helping her reach even more audience. So she was doing, college things and dinner theaters and things like that. And she was very surprised, after she was 60, let's just say, she was very surprised that young people were showing up to see her. And she couldn't figure out why for a really long time. And then she did. And she just realized that, the younger generation, my generation, which is considered by her to be the younger generation, and the younger generation that's considered by me to be the younger generation, we all have the same exact stress and anxiety and fear of failure in that arena. So she's universal. And, I just wanted to memorialize her today because God knows we have bounced our boobies with her for, I was trying to figure it out. I'm guessing more than 15 years. More than 15 years. So thank you. Knockers up, everybody. Rusty, rest in peace. Go with the angels. Every burlesque queen in America salutes you. Every body broad salutes you. Every bad girl trying to be good. We all salute you. So thank you so much for indulging me. Anyway, It was sad news. It was really sad. I got the news last night, and I got it through a mutual friend, which is a good way to get it. I didn't have to read it on the internets. There was very little about her on the internets, I must say. But I will say, you know, props to Elaine Boozler, who tweeted it and put it on her Facebook page, and other female comedians who did the same. I really feel like I had a special bond with her, and I'm very lucky to be able to say that. Anyway, 9 dead in San Jose. Welcome, everybody, to the Death Hour. Yeah. Well, at least Rusty passed peacefully. Natural causes and all, 91 years old. Or as Lisa, a mutual friend, said, she was effing old. Yeah. So, but nine people from 29 to 63. Mass murder. Shot.